So, as you know, it's a ritual for me to say farewell to a webtoon, especially one that I have followed, especially one that I have definitely talked about. And I know this video is very, very late, but I'm going to do it regardless. And today I'm here to say farewell to A Good Day to Be a Dog. It's truly an incredible series. It really surprised me to how good it was. It's definitely a series that you gotta check out. I love the ending, even though the ending kinda left on a cliffhanger, but I think the ending was satisfying enough. The ending was really good because the antagonist of the entire series was actually the protagonist supporting the other two protagonists all along. It was very devious, it was very good writing, it was hyper intelligent, and I respect the author so much for what they did. Good Day to Be a Dog. If you're just watching the video, what is Good Day to Be a Dog? So it follows the young lady of the name of Miss Han, who's a pretty regular girl. Very ordinary. Went to school, went to college, became a teacher, has a job. That's it. She's special. She's normal, except for one thing. She turns into a dog every time she kisses a man. And the only way to reverse that curse is if she kisses the same guy whose conscience back, and she won't turn into a dog again. This, of course, leaves her single because not many people either want to kiss her or can handle the fact that she turns into a dog. The curse was set to stop them from dating, and it truly does that to an absolute T. But the story takes a twist and a turn with someone that she thought hated her was actually deeply in love with her. He just didn't know what to do. I'll leave it at that, and we'll continue on. The series recently just ended with probably about 90 or so chapters, and the ending was actually page gripping and actually very, very intelligently well done, if I do say so myself. Again, it really tricked the audience to believe one thing, and in truth, the author had a whole other plan that was going along, which again was truly, truly amazing. What I really like about Good Day to Be a Dog is how serious it was. It painted itself as a drama, but it had a lot of humoric elements to it. It was serious enough to where you took it seriously, but not super serious to where it was very dark. It really just took a different side of love and really explored the different facets of it. And honestly, the character that stands out to me most is Sion, because, and I knew before he even admitted it, I just knew that Sion just had a big crush on Miss Han. Like I said, and again, and I've said this before, but anybody who just hates you that much, it's something else going on. And I just knew that he just hated Miss Han a little too much for it to not be normal. He must have had either A, a big crush on her, or B, something else, or he was like the mountain spirit or something like that. But he just hated her too much for really no reason. And if someone really hates you for no reason, this is really actually a life lesson. Because it's so true. It's something they it may not be there in love with you, but it's something else there. Like, it's something more to it. And really, people who are in love, they're not really going to say that they're in love, because that's a whole vulnerability thing. And I can have this whole love discussion for about 45 minutes, but you're not here for a love session, you're here for an actual webtoon video. So let's get back to it. But it really stuck out to me because I really liked how it really gives you hope that you can get the person that you're in love with, because the odds of him getting who he loved was very, very dim, because she was heads over heels over somebody else, and then she had her curse as well. He was also coupled with the feeling of fear of dogs, so he wasn't really interested in a person like myself from the very beginning. So the odds were always stacked into their favor, and that's one of the things that Bogan mentioned, which is why I really like him as a character, was in the sense of they were throughout many different timelines, it just didn't work out with them. He tried to get them together so much, but there was always a factor that prevented it, and that he finally completed his goal, and he got two people that he wanted to get together together. So they had so many things against them, and the sheer fact that that didn't happen was actually a breath of fresh air. Again, Sion really just sticks up to me as a character, and actually Bogum too, because his character development from near the end was absolutely thriller perfect. Like, it was so good. One, it caught you off guard. You really weren't expecting it. You knew Bogum was up to something,
but you really just didn't know what until the final arc of the webtoon actually came into existence. But what was also really good was that we're given like tons of chapters of them just being in love to really be told that their paradise is about to be in jeopardy. Absolutely perfect. Just amazing. Great. If you want to make a webtoon, this is how you do it. This is how you do it. This is how you grasp your audience. This is how you make a love story. Take notes because the Koreans actually know what they're doing. And it was actually just a page-gripping thriller every time you just read every chapter. So again, I just really think that it was just meticulously well done, very, very psychologically well done as well. And Seon, again, it's just a character that shines out to me most because he really gives hope to a lot of people where you can get that person that you're in love with the most, even if it's them. Feelings can change and you can fall for somebody. You know, love does exist. And if one thing that this webtoon really just stresses is that love can exist. And no matter how grim your situation is, there's a chance for you to fall in love and to be married. Because there was no hope for Miss Han. Oh, there was no hope for Seon. But miraculously, just life happened and both of them are together and they're very, very happy and they're in love. It just gives you so much hope. It's not really good in the real world because in the real world, it's just really sucky, especially in the dating world. I know this from experience. But it's nice to have a breath of fresh air in the form of a webtoon that says, hey, you know what? You can probably get that person that you love the most. You can probably go out with them, hold their hand, kiss them, eat dinner, and just really genuinely get to know about them. There's no other better feeling than the power of love. And Good Day to Be a Dog definitely told that to Perfect T. It's just a feeling that comes when you're meeting somebody and you're getting to know them and you want to take your feelings further, but you don't really know how. You don't know how that person will see. You're going back and forth because you really like this person, but you just don't know when it's the right move. All that is actually very good and very invigorating, but it is also very frustrating as well. And it really causes a lot of strife, especially when you play the game called Love. Case in point, I just really farewell to Good Day to Be a Dog. I'm looking for whatever the author has to make in the future. Again, really good, top-notch webtoon. Honestly, there's nothing more that I can say about it. It was amazing. I'm glad I found it. I'm glad I talked about it. I'm glad it's on my channel. I'm glad I read it. Thank you so much, Good Day to Be a Dog, for all the lovely work that you did. And that's the end of my video. If you like what I do and if you like webtoons, why don't you follow the Discord down in the description below? I just opened up a Discord so you can talk to other people who are like you in the same webtoons or manga, wherever you like. So why don't you just join all the fun? If you also like this video, make sure you leave a like and a subscribe. But honestly, really, leave a subscribe to your favorite creators because it helps them out a lot. With that being said, I'll see you in the next video or whatever I make. Peace.